As you would expect from its name, during human development, growth hormone stimulates and regulates the growth and development of most tissues. However, it also plays an important role in adults by regulating bone mass and blood nutrient levels. Growth hormone exerts its effects via various pathways summarized in this slide. It stimulates amino acid uptake by cells and protein synthesis. It increases lipolysis, making fatty acids available for energy metabolism, and it also increases blood glucose by stimulating glycogen breakdown in the liver. All these effects are required for healthy growth in infants. Growth hormone also stimulates the release of insulin-like growth factors, or IGFs, from various tissues. The IGFs promote growth of specific tissues such as bone and cartilage. In adults, the growth hormone has a so-called glucose-sparing effect. Here, the glucose in the blood is spared for use by the brain. This is especially important during times of fasting when resources are limited. This occurs daily when we are sleeping, and it is known that growth hormone levels rise during these times. Growth hormone is produced and secreted by the anterior pituitary gland, and like all such hormones, its release is regulated by the hypothalamus. Growth hormone releasing hormone stimulates the release of growth hormone, whereas growth hormone inhibiting hormone inhibits its release. These two hormones are further regulated by negative feedback. A rise in growth hormone and IGF levels will inhibit the release of growth hormone releasing hormone, but will stimulate the release of the inhibiting hormone. The release of these two hormones can further be modified by various blood nutrient levels. For example, lowering blood glucose levels will stimulate the release of the growth hormone releasing hormone. Abnormal secretion of growth hormone can lead to several pathological conditions. In many cases, hyper or hyposecretion of growth hormone results from pituitary adenomas, which are non-cancerous tumors found in the pituitary gland. An increase in growth hormone levels in children before the epiphyseal plates have ossified results in gigantism, where the long bone growth is exaggerated. Hyposecretion of growth hormone in childhood results in the opposite problem, dwarfism. If an excess of growth hormone is secreted after the epiphyseal plates have ossified, then the bones will no longer lengthen. However, they will continue to increase in diameter, and individuals will develop a prominent jawline, an enlarged brow, and a thickening of the joints. This condition is called acromegaly, and it is what Andre the Giant suffered from.